In this class, I will explain you how to design a two-span continuous beam using the concept of redistribution of moments. In the last lecture, I had explained about redistribution of moments. So here, let us take the example of a two-span continuous beam to illustrate that concept. Now, let me take a problem of two-span continuous beam like this. So it is simply supported at all the three supports. Its span is 8 meters each. And instead of giving the loads, I will take the factored moments itself. So factored moments are given by this. These are the factored moments, that means design moments. So factored moments at the mid-spans, MD and MD values, it is given as 200 kilometer meters. You know that it is sagging in nature. And at the support B, middle support B, it is 400 km meter, which is hardening nature. And shear force is maximum at the support B, and its value is 100 kN. And grade of concrete is 25, and the steel grade is 5405. And he has given 25% redistribution of moments, 25%. So that means the maximum allowable percentage of redistribution of moment is 30%. So he can give any value below 30%. Here in this problem, he has given 25% redistribution of moment. So the concept of redistribution of moment is at the support, the value is 400 here, at the midspan is 400 here. So you cannot provide different sections at support as well as at the midspan. So in order to avoid that, you can provide, but in order to avoid that, let us have that 25% redistribution of moments without causing a difference in the design. So the design moments now become after allowing for the redistribution. So at the support it is reduced, and at the mid-span it is increased. So 25% it is reduced in the support, and at the mid-span it is 25% increased. So here, so at support it becomes 400 minus 0.25, that is 25% of 400. Which comes out to be 300 kN, which is hardening in nature. And at mid-span it is 200, given is 200 plus 25% of 400, which also comes to be 300 kN, but it is sagging in nature. So in this problem, of course, we got the same value of design moments, both at the support and at the mid-span. So only thing is, the nature of the moment is different, and the reinforcement pattern which we are going to provide is different, that's all. Now, these are the values of design moments for which we have to design the beam. So, we have to assume the initially, for preliminary design, we have to assume some suitable depth of the beam. So, according to the code, we can assume any value between 1 by 12 to 1 by 20 of the span. It comes out to be here, the span is 8 meters here, that is 8000 mm. So, 8000 by 12 to 8000 by 20 mm, it comes out to be 667 to 400 mm, so say 450 mm. You can go for 500 mm also. So let us go for 450 mm, that is the value between these two. And considering effective cover for the beam as 50 mm, so your overall depth becomes 500 mm. So overall depth is 500 mm. Anyway, we are not calculating any dead load, live load and all. Directly, moments are given. But normally, in a practical problem, you will be knowing the loads acting on the continuous beam. Normally, this redistribution of moment and those moment coefficients, they are all applicable provided the loads are uniformly distributed loads. So, suppose if the continuous beam is subjected to uniformly distributed load throughout, then those coefficients on this redistribution of moment concept can be used. So, here there is no need to calculate the loads directly, moments are known and shear force is known. Now here, the reinforcements are calculated like this. I am going to use SP16 directly. I am not going to use any IS456 code for doing this problem. So all of you should know how to use SP16. Directly you can get the reinforcements and the spacing of the bars. That is very important. It saves a lot of time. Otherwise, you have to solve some equations to get the value of ASP and the spacing of the bars. Here, I will take the support section. So support section is B. So at B, the moment we have to design the reinforcement for this moment. 300 kN meter is the mu value, actual moment value or design moment value. Grade of concrete in this problem is given 25. Please note 25. And Fy is 415. B we have taken, we have, let us assume B as 250. Normally B is taken half of B. Okay, 1.52 times B, that is the for preliminary design. We are going to take the value of B, width of the B. So here I will take D as B as half of capital D. That is it comes 500 by 250. Now I am going to use this SP16 chart now. So for using SP16 chart, so in page 51, table is there. Page 87, table 51 is there. That table is for this combination. So different tables are available for different combinations of concrete and steel. So in this problem, he has given FCK at 25 N/m² and Fy 415 N/m². For the combination of concrete and steel, so this is the table we have to refer. So we need to calculate. So one thing called mu lim by FCK width. Before using the table, let us check whether the section is under a single reinforced or double reinforced. So we have to check that. So for that, so we have to calculate this quantity mu lim by FCK width square as per IS 4.6. We have to calculate this ratio mu lim by FCK width square. Check whether we have to go for singly or double reinforced section. This is very important. Once you decide whether singly or double reinforced section, then directly using SP16 we can get the steel required. Now mu lim by FCK width square is equal to 0.138. This is for Fy is equal to 415 N/m². This is given in the code as well as in SP16 also it is available. So from this we can calculate the mu lim value for that particular section and grade of concrete. So mu lim is equal to 0.138 into 25. FCK is 25, I into B is 250, D is 450 square. You are going to get a newton millimeter. So if you convert it to kilonewton meter, it comes out to be 174.65 kilonewton meter. Now you can observe that this mu lim is less than mu. Mu is the actual design moment for which we have to design the section. But mu lim, this is for a single reinforced section. Since this is coming less than mu, you have to go for double reinforced section. This is the criteria. So if mu lim is equal to or greater than mu, then you can go for single reinforced section. If mu lim is less than mu, you have to go for double reinforced section. Now you have to go to table 51, which is for double reinforced section. After deciding whether it is singly reinforced section or double reinforced section, then we have to choose the suitable table from SP16. For tables are available for both singly reinforced and double reinforced sections. So directly you get the reinforcement percentage, and from the reinforcement percentage you can calculate the steel reinforcement in area required. Now this is how we have to provide the reinforcement. So in the case of support section, so main steel is provided, tension steel is provided at the top, and compression steel is provided at the bottom. That you know, because of the hardening moment nature. Now I will take here D dash as 50 mm, that is the cover on the compression to the compression steel. Effective depth 450 mm. Then D dash by D ratio we need to use this table, which comes out to be 0.11. Round it up to 0.1, no problem, because the values are given for 0.11, 0.15, 0.2, like the nearest you can take 0.1. So now we have to calculate one ratio called mu by bd square. So mu is this value 300 kN meter, which you can convert to newton millimeter, 300 into 10 power 6, that is newton millimeter, and this value is 250 into 450 square. So this value is the B value and D value. If you simplify this, you will get 5.926. So from the table 51, for the value mu by bd square is equal to 5.926, so you have to get the PT and PC value that is given. Of course, directly you won't get, you have to interpolate, because exact value of w by bd square whatever is given in the table you may not get here. So you have to interpolate the percentage of steel. Pt is nothing but the tension steel, whereas Pc is nothing but the compression steel. So we need to calculate both because it is W for the section. So after getting the Pt, that is percentage of tension steel, percentage of compression steel Pc, you have to get the ASC, that is area of steel required, which is given by ASC is equal to Pt divided by 100 into the area, that is the cross section, sectional area of the beam. So sectional area of the beam is B into small d, percentage is 1.9915 divided by 100. So you will be getting 2154 millimeter square, that is the ASC required. If you assume 25 bars, you require 4 point something bars, it can only up to 5. So you can provide 5 of 25 bars. If you go for 20 bars, I think you may require 7 bars. Similarly, ASC will be PC, percentage of compression steel divided by 100 into once again B into D, so which is 855 millimeter square. So same diameter, if you assume 25 only 2 bars are enough, 2 bars are enough, because the area of 125 diameter bar is almost 490 millimeter square, that you can calculate. So this is what, this is how you can calculate the number of bars. Assume the diameter of the bar and number of bars you calculate. So this is the steel that is to be provided at the support section. So it is shown here. You can see reinforcement is shown here. So this is 500, overall depth is 500, width is 250 mm, ASC is for at the top, ASC is for at the bottom. So ASC is 5 of 25, this is 2 of 25. So 2 of 25, this is 5 of 25. This is the cross section at the support. Now similarly you have to design the reinforcement at the mid span, D or E. So here the moment that we have to take as per second 300, since both these values are same, so MU at support and MU at mid span both are same, you need not do the design once again for PT and PC, because we are going to get the same values. But only in this problem it is coming like that. Suppose if they give 20% redistribution of moments in this case, then this becomes 400 minus 0.2 into 400, that is 80, 320, this becomes 320, this becomes 280. So please note that 320, 280, then you have to recalculate once again this. MU becomes 280 then. So then you have to, of course, once again it becomes a W for section. So for that value of MU by BD square, so whatever value you get, you have to calculate PT and PC. So here, since both the values you are getting same, 300 and 300, you need not calculate ASC and ASC separately. So same reinforcement you can provide. So but only thing is, ASC is provided at the bottom, ASC is provided at the top, because the bending moment is sagging in nature. So you can see here, this is the reinforcement. So it is reversed here. So 5 bars of 25 at the bottom, 2 bars of 25 at the top. This is at the mid-span section, that is at D and E. So please note that if the values of moments are same, then you need not design second part, second section, it remains same. But not in all the cases it will like that, normally values should be different. In this case it has come same, that's all. So if it is different, you have to do these steps. You have to do these steps for this mid-span section also. Now the last thing is, we have to check for shear. So design for shear. So nominal shear stress, so we have to calculate, which is Vu by Vd. Vu is the factor shear for this particular Vu. Now P is the particular Vu, 100 kN has given. So 100 into 10 cube divided by 250 into 250, because that's converted into Newton, and this one into millimeter square. So Newton per millimeter square, you are going to get 0.89. That is nominal shear stress. And the percentage shear stress, tension reinforcement you have provided is 1.915%. So we have to calculate one thing called permissible shear strength of concrete, ρc. So certain amount of shear is taken by concrete also. So you have to design the stirrups only for the balance shear. So whatever shear steel has to take up, for that you have to design the stirrups. So total shear is 100 kN, out of which concrete will take this 2C into BD. So this much is the shear taken by concrete. How to get this 2C? Once again, you have a table 61 in SP16. Of course, in IS-456 also table is there. So depending on the grade of concrete, that is M25 grade, that is FCK is 25, and the percentage of steel provided, that you can get the value of 2C. So that is the permissible or allowable shear strength of concrete. So BU minus 2C gives the shear taken by steel. Shear that is taken by steel. So BUS is equal to BU minus 2C BD. So you will be getting 10,000 newton. In newtons, you can express this. So this is the amount of shear we have to design this shear. So this shear reinforcement is necessary only if tau V is greater than tau C. So if tau V is greater than tau C, shear reinforcement you have to design. Otherwise, you can go for nominal shear reinforcement. Of course, once again, we have to calculate only from SP16, you can directly get the value. So you have a VUS by D in the next page. So the VUS by D you have to calculate. So of course, VUS should be in kilometers, D should be in centimeters, so 10 by 45.22. So one table is there in the SP16. I am telling the table number. So from the table, using the table number, you can easily get the value of spacing of the boss. You can easily get that. I think the page number is 179. So page 179, SP16, page 179, one table is provided. So in that table, based on the value of VUS by D, you can assume the two length, the 8 mm fillets properly is assumed. So spacing directly is given. Of course, in that table, this 0.22 value is not at all there. Since that 0.22 value is not there, so you can provide a nominal addition, that is at 300 mm. Center as the stirrups. So these stirrups are, so these are the stirrups. They are two length tall inch at 300 mm. The tall unit we can go for 450 mm also. 450 mm also is okay because the highest spacing is 450. A very small amount of shear force is taken by steel. So this completes the design of two span continuous beam. So please keep it in mind, I have done this problem by taking the redistribution of moment concept and by using SP16 directly. So you should be in a position to use SP16 because it will be provided in the examination. Both IS-456 and SP16 will be provided. So what I have done here is, I have designed section at support and as well as section at midspan separately. Section at support carries arching bending moment. Section at midspan carries sagging bending moment. Only reinforcement pattern will be different. So first we have to check whether we have to provide a singly or double reinforced section. So if MU limb value is greater than or equal to MU value, it is singly reinforced. If MU limb value is less than MU value, you have to go for double reinforced. Then based on the senior double reinforced, you have to choose the respective table from SP16 book. Different tables are available for different grades of concrete and steel. From that, you can directly get the values of the percentage of tension steel and compression steel by taking this ratio, MU by BD square. Then later on, you can calculate the steel that is required in area. In terms of area, once you get, you can assume the diameter is for a number of what you can compute. And result for shear is also done by calculating nominal shear stress, comparing that with the permissible shear stress of concrete. So then balance shear that is taken by steel, and that for balance shear, so assuming the two length 8 mm bars or 10 mm bars depending on the problem value, so stirrups, so you can calculate the spacing of the bars. So then you can sketch the diameter. They ask you to sketch the longitudinal section as well as the cross section. Please draw rough sketch of that. Here I have to only cross sections. Longitudinal section also you can show in longer section, you can show the main boss. Main boss at the support as well as at the mid spans, you can show in one stretch. So this completes the design. So of course, you have not done the check for depression and all. So if you ask me to design, you can go up to this. So in field, actually, you need to check for depression also. Once again, that is done using the IL456.